If you're not following me on Instagram, please do follow, because we are uploading many behind the scene pictures and videos there.
Hit that subscribe button and bell icon so you never miss an update from Neela Bakore Tutorials.
In this part, we'll talk about two viral diseases and we will compare both these diseases, their symptoms and causative agents. Like in the previous video, we talked about two similar kind of diseases, that is chickenpox and smallpox. So now we will be talking about measles and German measles. Both are viral diseases, and the virus that causes is RNA virus. So it is caused by, measles is caused by measles virus, and it is an RNA virus. That means the genetic material is RNA, and same is in case of German measles, that is the virus is RNA, but it is called rubeola. And the virus is also known as rubeola virus, and it is also RNA virus. So here in both these viruses, the genetic material is RNA. Measles is more contagious. And is more serious also. Whereas German measles is not that severe, not that contagious, but there is one condition which we will talk about a little later, less serious as compared to measles. Symptoms. In case of measles, white rash-like structure appears in mouth, but those are patches. So white patches appear in mouth, and then the rashes would appear on the body. So first is white patches in the mouth, then fever, and then there is rash. In case of German measles, the rashes appear directly, no white patches, and these rashes appear in upper body, or rather on upper body and face first, and then those rashes, they start to appear on the lower part of the body. In this case, in case of German measles, the other symptoms include fever, sneezing, coughing, and there is swelling of lymph nodes. Swelling of lymph nodes. And the reason is, in case of measles, the virus is found in the respiratory tract. So virus normally infects or lives in respiratory tract. Whereas in case of German measles, the virus lives in lymph nodes, eyes, and skin. And that is why there is inflammation in the eyes also, skin also, and that is why the rashes appear. So symptoms wise, there are some differences. We talked about the severity or the seriousness of these two diseases. Measles is more common, it spreads more commonly. German measles is not that effective, not that serious, except if a pregnant female gets German measles, because this virus, rubeola virus, can cross placenta. So this is the special thing. This virus can cross placenta and affect the fetus. So if the pregnant female, a pregnant female gets infected by simple measles, the symptoms are going to be a little more severe, but there is no damage or no harm to the fetus. Whereas in case of German measles, the female may get milder symptoms, but the chances of fetus getting affected are very high. The reason is that this virus can cross the placental barrier. Now, how do we control or cure, or is there any kind of vaccination for this? So the vaccination or the vaccine is called MMR. It is for three diseases: mumps, measles, and rubella. That means it is for measles as well as German measles. So this vaccine is available, which is given against three diseases. We will be talking about mumps also later, but measles and rubella along with mumps, and the vaccine is called MMR. So German measles are dangerous in one sense that the virus can cross the placental barrier and can harm the fetus, and the symptom-wise severity is more in case of measles. So both are viral diseases. In fact, the symptoms are pretty much similar. In both the cases, there would be rashes, there would be fever, but there are some characteristic features in the symptoms which can be used to distinguish whether it is simple measles or a German measles. Now, in the next part, we will take up some more viral diseases.